Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh to the viewers out there. We are all aware that we are in the last 10 nights of Ramadan, which is the ultimate in terms of spirituality and blessedness in the month of Ramadan. In many ways, many of us might be physically exhausted, we might be tired, but yet to give an expression and an example, it is like a racer who is coming towards the end of his race, seeing the finishing line. He doesn't slow down, he doesn't slack down. If he does slow down, it actually means his defeat. As he sees the finishing line, he even runs faster. This is the example for us. We might be tired, but as we come towards the end of Ramadan, we are supposed to exert ourselves even more, make greater effort to find Laylatul Qadr. We are all aware of the blessedness of Laylatul Qadr. What more can we say than what Allah has said in the Holy Quran? Laylatul Qadr khayrun min alf shahr. Laylatul Qadr is even more superior and more greater than 1,000 months. How much more greater, only Allah Ta'ala knows. There's one very subtle aspect and dimension of Laylatul Qadr I want to draw your attention towards. Allah says, تَنَزَّلُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ وَالْرُوحُ فِيهَا بِإِذْنِ رَبِّهِمْ مِنْ كُلِّ أَمْرٍ. And just a small background with regard to this. Allah has placed His love in the heart of every human being, whether he be a believer or he be a person who does not believe in Allah. Allah has placed His love in the heart of every human being. Now, the believer, his love for Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is even more. Allah says in the Quran, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَّدُّ حُبًّا لِلَّهِ. The believer is intense in his love for Almighty Allah. He is passionate. He loves Allah more than anything else, more than his family, more than a football team, more than anything else. Now, when you love someone, it's a natural thing that you would like to meet your beloved. Now, there are two ways that we can meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One is dependent upon us leaving this world, because that's the only time we will be able to see Allah when we are in the next world, in the next realm. That is why our ulama say, Al-mawtu jusrun yusiru al-habib ila al-habib. That death is a bridge through which the lover meets the beloved. So our way of meeting Allah and seeing Allah directly will be in another realm. There's another way of meeting. And that is when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes down to meet us. The night of Laylatul Qadr is that night. We are all aware of the hadith that Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had said, that on a night of power, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes down to the first heaven, and He comes down to meet human beings and ask, is there anyone who seeks forgiveness that I can forgive him? Is there anyone who seeks risk that I can grant him risk? Is there anyone who has any need that I can fulfill so that I can fulfill it? So Allah ta'ala comes down to meet us. And then there is another way where, even in this world, we find that before you go somewhere, you want to go and meet someone, you send your special envoy to go and meet the person whom you are going to meet or send a very important message. Allah in Surah Al-Qadr tells us, Allah sends His special envoy to meet with us on Laylatul Qadr. تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم من كل أمر سلام هي حتى مطلع الفجر. That special envoy is the angels. And not only the angel. Hazrat Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam, Allah Ta'ala sends down, O Jibreel, go and meet my believers. Go and meet the one who is supposed to have love for me. Go and meet him, and he comes to meet us. And he comes down right up till Fajr. The point is, we as believers have more love for Allah than anything else in this world. And Allah Ta'ala says, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَّدُّ حُبًّا لِلَّهِ. And when you love someone, you like to meet the beloved. One way of meeting is, Allah comes down to ask, what do you want from me? Allah sends His angels to say, go and see what my believers and those who love me, what are they doing? Are they asking of me? Are they turning towards me? Are they performing Salat? The question with which I will conclude, what will we be doing when Allah comes down to meet us? when Allah comes down to ask us, what do you want from me? When Allah sends down Jibreel to come and see what we are doing, will we be performing Salah or watching Salah? Will we be actually responding to Allah Ta'ala's call, what do you want from me? Or would we be doing something that is mundane, perhaps trendy for 90 minutes? That question is up to you. Jazakumullah.
We here at the Ummah Squad are proud to announce a program that's going to be happening on the 27th of Ramadan, inshallah. A program definitely not to be missed at the Nurul Islam Masjid in Lanesia, commencing at 7:05 p.m. with Taraweeh. Post the Taraweeh, world-renowned Maulana Bilal Mullah Damat Barakatuhum will be addressing the crowd. Thereafter, inshallah, after the lecture, there will be refreshments that will be served so their brothers can remain in the masjid. Why? Because at 10:30 p.m. another program is going to be commencing. Spend the next few hours in the company of legends like Hafiz Yasin Chunara, but Maulana Yusuf Pandor, Maulana Yasin Kaji, Qari Usama Isha, Qari Yusuf Osman, and Qari Muhammad Umar Bashir. That is definitely a program not to be missed. This is an opportunity set out for us to make it easier for us to spend the night in the masjid, inshallah. If you wish to come along with your bedding, please do so. Arrangements have been made, and try and search for Qadr this 27th night at the Nurul Islam Masjid or any masjid that you wish to do so. Ball is now in your court. Sacrifice those 90 minutes and see what Allah will do for you. It's not only about 1,000 months of reward or more. Allah will give you His pleasure. Sacrifice your leisure for the pleasure of Allah. May Allah bless us all.